So in this video, we're going to go over a worked example where we find the direction of maximum increase. So here's the problem. It says, suppose we have a metal sheet, and the metal sheet has a temperature filled in Celsius modeled by temperature as a function of position. So the XY coordinates give you a position on the metal plate, and the temperature is described by 100 minus X squared minus 2Y squared. It says, if a heat-seeking particle was placed on the sheet at the point 4, 3, in which direction would it move? And if x, y coordinates are measured in centimeters, what is the rate of temperature increase in that direction? So if a heat-seeking particle is going to move in the direction of maximum heat change, it's going to seek an increase in heat. So what we want to recognize is that the gradient is going to point in the direction of maximum increase. So the first step is to calculate the gradient of our temperature filled model. So the gradient of the temperature filled model is going to be the partial derivative with respect to x. So looking at the model that we have here, I see that the partial derivative with respect to x is minus 2x. And then the second component of the gradient is going to be the partial derivative with respect to y, which is going to be, looking at the model, going to be minus 4 times y. I do have a constant of 2 that is shared by both terms, so I could factor it out. I probably want to leave the negative signs inside the vector so I don't make a silly mistake, because the negative signs are going to play into giving me direction. So the gradient, or the direction of greatest heat, greatest rate of change of heat for the whole temperature field is given by the gradient. And then we want to know what the gradient is at a specific position on the plate. So we would calculate the gradient at that position. So the gradient at the position 4, 3 is going to be equal to 2 times the opposite of x, comma negative 2 times y, which is just going to be negative 6. And I could pull out another positive 2 if I wanted, which would give me 4 times negative 2 and negative 3. So the direction that the heat-seeking particle should move in to get the greatest increase in heat is going to be, so the direction it should move in is the direction negative 2, negative 3. Now technically we say move in the direction of the gradient, so the gradient is negative 8, negative 12, but this is just a positive scalar, so the vector negative 2, negative 3 is parallel to the vector negative 8, negative 12, so it still tells me the direction in which I need to move. And that's really all the question is asking, is which direction. It doesn't say I need to know a unit vector in the direction of motion or anything like that. So I move in this direction. We could answer the question, you know, if we had a cold-seeking particle, which direction should it move in? And if we had a cold-seeking particle, we would want it to move in the opposite of the gradient vector, opposite direction of the gradient vector. So a cold-seeking particle would want to move in the direction 2, 3. To experience the greatest heat, decrease in heat. So it also says, what is the rate of change of temperature if the particle moves in the direction of greatest temperature increase? So that's just going to be given by the size of the gradient vector at 4, 3. So the size of the gradient vector at 4, 3 is just going to be 4. And that's why having the positive constant factored out is front, because we can just go 4 times the square root of the sum of the squares of the vector components, which are negative 2 and negative 3. So having that 4 factored out here, the positive constant, it's going to save a little bit of simplifying. So 4 times the square root, and we get 4 plus 9 is 13. So 4 times the square root of 13, and this is a rate of change. This is a derivative, so it's going to be 4 times the square root of 13 degrees Fahrenheit per and XY positions are measured in centimeters, so degrees Fahrenheit per centimeter moved is the rate of change of temperature in the direction of maximum temperature change. If we were moving in the direction of minimum, the least temperature change, we would move in the direction 2, 3, and we would be losing 4 root 13 degrees Fahrenheit per centimeter, because this would be negated. We could also ask a question which isn't asked in the problem. We could say, which direction should you move in if you don't want to experience temperature change, if you want the rate of change of temperature to be zero? So in other words, how do you move along the plate from the 0.43 so that as you move along the plate, the temperature doesn't change? You're in an area, you move along a level curve of constant temperature. And what we want to remember is that to move in a direction of no temperature change, we want to move perpendicular to the gradient vector. So here the gradient vector is in this direction, so to move perpendicular to the gradient vector, I just need to move in a direction that's orthogonal to the vector negative 2, negative 3. So let's just build an orthogonal vector. So build a vector AB that's orthogonal to the vector 2, 3. And the way that we do it is we remember that the dot product of orthogonal vectors has to equal 0. So we just need to find a vector AB so that when we dot it with negative 2, negative 3, we get 0, and then we know we have an orthogonal or perpendicular vector, right? My gradient vector is sitting right here. He's negative 2, negative 3. I'd like to build some vector AB that's orthogonal to it so that we're moving in a direction of no heat change. So we take the dot product. We get negative 2 times A minus 3 times B, and this needs to equal 0. And so the idea is that our choice of A and B are kind of arbitrary. So for example, I could just decide to let A be 1. I'm going to let A be equal to 1. And if I do that, I get negative 2 times 1 is negative 2 minus 3B has to equal 0. This means that negative 3 times B has to equal 2, or B has to be negative 2 thirds. So the vector 1 comma negative 2 thirds is orthogonal to the vector negative 2, negative 3, and if I move in this direction, I'll experience no heat change. If I don't like the fraction, I can just scale it, because any scaled vector is still parallel to the original vector. So I could just scale this by a factor of 3 and get the vector 3, negative 2, and voila, I have a vector with nice integer values that's perpendicular to the gradient vector. So if I move in this direction, 3, negative 2, hey, I will experience no heat change if I move in that direction. And then we want to recognize that, hey, we could also move in this direction and still be perpendicular to the gradient vector. So how could I get a vector pointing in this direction? You know, that one that's at we get two vectors, one at 90 degrees and one at 270 degrees. Well, I just negate this one, right? If I negate this vector, it's going to bounce it in the other direction. So it'll be parallel but facing the opposite direction. So I can say move in the direction 3, negative 2, or move in the direction negative 3, 2, and you'll be moving in a direction of no temperature change.